Good evening, beloved. I gotta bid y'all. Good night. But before I leave you, I need to tell you, you can make it on broken pieces. Because even though all you have is just a piece, you still have all of the promise. In chapter 23 and the 11th verse, the Lord told Paul, just like you witnessed for me in Jerusalem, I'm going to have you to witness for me in Rome. He didn't that he would have to go through before he would ever get to Rome. He just told him, you're going to witness for me when you get to Rome. He didn't tell him that there would be a falling out between him and John Mark. He did not tell him that Alexander the coppersmith would not do him much harm. Lord, he did not tell him that Demas would never forsake him. He just told him, you're going to witness for me when you get to Rome. He did not tell him that he wouldn't receive death threats in Jerusalem, or pray in the name and Thessalonica. He just told him, you're going to be my witness when you get to Rome. He didn't tell him that you wouldn't be stoned to death in Lystra. He didn't tell him that you'd be left for dead. He simply told Paul, you're going to witness for me when you get to Rome. Oh, pray the name. And even though the storm was raging, and even though the ship was being busted up, I heard Paul a few verses earlier tell all of the prisoners, we're going to make it. Oh, pray the name. And he said, we're going to lose the ship, but everybody's going to get saved to land. Oh, pray the name. In my black colored African American, sanctified, eavesdropping, preaching, imagination, I heard Paul say, we gotta jump overboard. Oh, praise the name. In other words, when they left the ship, the rain was falling and the wind was blowing. Oh, praise the name. They had to jump in the water. You didn't hear what I said. I said, we, Paul and the other prisoners, had to jump overboard. They had to jump in the water. You still didn't get it. When he jumped overboard, they jumped in the water. Turn around and tell somebody, that means in order to make it, you gotta change the environment. Oh, praise the name. You gotta get wet. You gotta leave the convenience of apprenticeship, and you gotta get used to another environment. And while environment shifts, I tell you how you're going to make it. Catch a piece of the ship and let the wave carry out the promise. Good evening, BM&E. It's been good being here with you. It's been good serving you here. But I've got to bid y'all goodbye. But before I leave you, I need to remind you, you can make it because of God's promise. Oh, praise the name. Everybody else may experience failure. Some other people may let you down. But I'm a living witness. The Lord will keep his word. Is there anybody in the house who knows he will keep his word? Oh, praise the name. He'll keep his word because he knows how it feels to work with broken pieces. Oh, praise the name. the pieces. When he got his ministry off the ground, he went by the seashore and gathered up pieces. Oh, praise his name. And one Friday, on Friday, to take care of your sin and mine, I tell you what he did. He went to a hill called Calvary. And on that hill, he mastered the pieces. He died. Somebody said it was on a tree, but I stopped by to tell you it wasn't a whole tree, just the pieces. One piece stood upright. The other piece was attached crosswise. And I tell you what he did. He took the pieces, put a nail in one hand, put a nail in the other, took a spike in his feet, took a spear in his side, I put a crown on his head, he drunk his head, in the locks of his shoulder. Yeah! I said he died. If you know he died, turn around and shake one hand and tell a neighbor, if Jesus could handle the pieces, you can make it. Oh, broken pieces, I gotta leave you when I tell you, I've seen the lightning flashing. Jesus telling me to try it on. He promised forgiveness. He promised never leave me alone. Shake one more hand. Tell your neighbor, we're gonna make it. Yeah, we're gonna make it. We're gonna make it. Yeah. We're gonna make it. Anybody feel like praying in